Hi, it's David. I would like to show you how I built a high-end wood butcher block. So what are we gonna do? I prepared some piece of maple, hard rock maple only, because this is what we want. We want something very strong and solid. They are joint and plane, so I know they are square. So they are basically ready to glue. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna use the Bessie clamp to glue all the slab together. But before that, I would like to show you how I plan and how I visualize the wood grain to have like, or to maximize the effect on our wood block. So first of all, we're gonna put all the piece on the side here from the thickest to the thinnest. So we wanna make sure to balance our wood block very well. So I'm gonna work with pear. So this one. So this one is pretty by itself. So I'm gonna put it in the middle. I'm gonna put these two on each side. Then these two here. And these two beside the smallest one here. Oop, this one goes like this. So by balance, this is what I mean. You know, like I have like the lone wolf here in the middle and everything is symmetrical. Then if you're building a tabletop, you will need to take care of the direction of the grain to reverse it to make sure it will stay flat. But in this specific case, we just want to have the nicest effect. So only take in consideration the beauty of the wood grain on the side here. We're gonna glue everything together and the glue will hold the wood grain together. So it's not gonna move after we glue our wood block. All right, now that I'm done visualizing the grain direction on the end of the boards, I'm gonna draw a reference marker. With this reference marker, that will allow me to put all the wood piece on the clamp to apply glue on it and to make sure I am able to put the exact same order when I'm gonna glue it. So let's say if by mistake I put this piece here, on my reference marker, I will notice right away that this piece needs to go right here. So I just need to recreate the exact same drawing. So I'm gonna put my wood piece on the side here. I'm gonna install the Bessie clamp right here. So I'm gonna put all the piece together on the side. I'm gonna apply glue, roll it, and clamp it. When you're gonna use the clamp and apply the pressure, it's important to make sure the wood piece stay very flat. So make sure it doesn't go up and down. You want a flat surface as much as possible. We're done with clamping. We're gonna let the glue dry for at least an hour. We're gonna remove all the excess of glue with a scraper, unclamp it. We're gonna bring it to the workshop. I'm gonna caliper it in the planer. I'm gonna make all the cut on the table saw for the end grain part that we need. And we'll be back with these. So I have my maple slab. We're gonna go in the belt center. We're gonna put it at the right thickness, and we're gonna go at the panel saw to cut our strip of 2 3/8. As I show you in the workshop, it's important to put numbers to make sure you keep all the pieces in order. We're now ready to establish the direction of the grain. So what I think makes a nice iron wood block, it's to show the nicest pattern and reflection in the wood grain. So we can put all the pieces in the same direction, that will make something nice. But if we think a little bit, maybe we can turn the piece like this and find out these amazing reflection pattern that will show the people that will have a look at our work, the thought that we put in it and the skill we have. So this is what I'm proposing. We're gonna flip in pairs. Let's see here, there's a pattern that, you know, maybe we don't want to have this on top of our block. What you can do is just to flip it. So you keep the same pattern and you hide what you don't see under it. So again, to me, in my opinion, what makes a high-end wood block, it's how thick are the block and how big are the parts. It's not like small, little pieces. It's like more like thicker and nice piece of wood, and you can see like a nice pattern reflection. You can glue it like this, but you can notice here the joint, the lines of glue is our line. So if you want to push it a little bit farther, you can just stagger the piece like this. So the line or the joint of glue is not a line anymore, so it's stronger. So, in my opinion, I'm very happy with this pattern. I'm gonna put another mark to make sure I remember the order and the side. I decide to put each pieces. I'm gonna take my clamps, put some glue, and clamp it. Done with my glue up. It's very important you keep all these pieces really well aligned. If there's a piece sticking out, it's really important to push it back where it was or where it goes. You can use a clamp if it's very difficult. If you have a piece sticking out, you will spend hours sanding it. Next, I'm gonna let this dry for at least 2 hours. Then I'm gonna remove every excess of glue with a scraper, unclamp it, and bring it to the shop. We're gonna use the belt sander to polish it and sand it on both sides. Then the table saw to cut it all around, and we'll be back. I have our block here. The glue is dry. We're gonna go in the white belt sander to adjust the thickness of it and sand it, and back on the panel saw to cut it at the right dimension. We're back from the shop. So we pass it a couple times in the belt sander. We use the table saw to cut it all around. If you have any table saw, you can use jigsaw or a skill saw. Be careful. And we put a little quarter round all around it. Then we use orbital sander to sand it and polish it. I polish it till 400 grit. And I recommend you do so because the more polished it will be, it will feel like a glass, which is good because when you cut on it, bacteria won't get in. Next is the finish. You will need to apply one on it. Make sure you choose non-toxic, food-safe finish. Personally, I will use a mineral oil. It's important to reapply some finish. You will notice some discoloration while you're using the block, so make sure you put some more finish to make it beautiful and safe for food. If you take good care of it, it will last a very long time. It's a good thing, because you cut a tree to build that. Take care of it. My name is David. I hope you enjoyed the video. See you soon.